the classes of antibodies, means types of antibodies. Yes, there are 5 classes of antibodies. On the basis of the amino acid sequence present in the constant region of the heavy chain. What are the classes of antibodies? Yes, 5 classes. As we have discussed that antibodies are also known as immunoglobulins. And immunoglobulins are represented, abbreviated and represented as IG. So, what are the 5 classes and why they are? The classification is based on, the type of sequence, sequence of amino acids in the constant region, of heavy chain. Okay, so what are they? As immunoglobulins, antibodies are immunoglobulins. Antibodies are also known as immunoglobulins. That is represented by its abbreviation IG and followed by a letter depending upon the type of heavy chain. So, what are these? This is IgG. IgG, here G is for gamma chain. Heavy chain is gamma. Name of heavy chain. Okay. IgA. That means alpha. Heavy chain is alpha. IgM. Mu chain. Heavy chain is known as mu chain. Okay. Then IgE. Chain is epsilon. Epsilon. IgD. D for delta chain. Delta. When the heavy chain is delta. Okay, so for your ease, I have taken, just started with G and then A, M, E, D. So, you can remember for the 5 classes of antibodies are as gamed. Okay, so let us discuss the IgG. Start with the IgG. It is one of the principal antibody okay, these make the 80% of the total antibody, 80% of total antibodies found in the blood serum and produce and bind with the antigens, bind with the antigens of, or we can say can fight against, produced and fight against, we can say bind with the antigens of viruses, bacteria and fungi. They can pass through, the IgG antibodies can pass through placental barrier, through placental barrier. So, provide the immunity since the fetal stage before birth. Provide immunity. So, provide immunity since fetal stage. Okay, so they means before birth, this IgG provide immunity before. Provide immunity before birth. Why? Because it can pass through the placental barrier. It is given, IgG is given for the resistance of hepatitis and other diseases. Hepatitis and other diseases. As it makes the 80% of total antibodies, where it is important for one more question. When you are asked, most abundant globulin, immunoglobulin or antibody, that means IgG. The antibody which can pass through the placental barrier in the fetus, then IgG. Remember two questions. The most abundant antibody, then the antibody which can pass through, the antibody which can pass through the placental barrier, in the fetus. Of course, placenta means, you can understand, okay, and it work against, it bind with the antigens or epitopes of the antigenic component present on the surface of virus, bacteria and fungi. That means it can fight against the, gives resistance against the viruses, bacteria and fungi. Next, IgA. It is IgG present in blood serum and lymph. Remember where it is present? Present in IgG we are discussing. IgG present in blood serum or plasma and lymph. Most abundant antibody, and it can pass through the placental barrier. Okay? IgA. IgA is the principal antibody
It is a principal antibody or serum globulin, serum immunoglobulin. Found in serum, serum immunoglobulin
makes about 6% constitute the 6% of the total antibodies. 6% of total antibodies secreted by the B cells, and this makes the these are present in the exocrine secretions, present in the exocrine secretions like colostrum, the first milk, like colostrum. What is colostrum? First milk produce the milk even in in the milk the mucosa, the respiratory and mucosa lining, in the mucosa, mucosa secreted from respiratory mucosa membrane, respiratory and intestinal mucus or in mucin, in the protein, intestinal and respiratory mucin or mucus, tear and saliva. They protect the mucosa membrane against the attachment with the bacteria or virus. IgA protects the mucous membrane from the attachment of bacteria and viruses. Then IgM is a basic antibody they make the constitute the 14% of total antibodies present in serum. It is the first and the largest. It is the first antibody which is produced when the body first on the first exposure to an antigen. It is the largest. One more question important. Largest antibody among the all immunoglobulins. First antibody produce against the antibody, this is the antibody first produced against the first exposure
exposure to antigen.
This is the antibody produced first. Against the exposure to antigen. The main site of these antibodies is the main site. The main site of production is spleen. Okay, this is important for the one more question, and generally ask the largest antibody means antigen, that antibody M. So physically largest
pentamer, it is a pentamer,
and antibody produced against the initial exposure, to the antigen, and the major or main site of production is the spleen. Okay, let us discuss the DNA. IgE plays important role in allergic reactions. Is the important role in allergic reactions. It constitutes the 0.002% of total antibodies. It means the 0.002% of the antibodies. These antibodies are produced when infection occurs by the parasitic worms produced against the infection caused by parasitic worms and infection caused by arthropods. Okay, IgE are produced against the infection caused by the parasitic worms and arthropods. It is produced primarily in the lungs, skins, and the mucous membranes. IgD. What question for IgE? Yes, it is important when it is asked for the anti-allergic or the antibody produced during the allergic reaction or anti-allergic antibody. Then you have to answer IgE and IgD. IgD is a specific immunoglobulin. Much is not known about the IgD, but however, the IgD immunoglobulin is present on the surface of B lymphocytes or B cells
and work as receptors. Work as receptors and bind with antigens. Bind with antigen because they work like the receptors on the surface of the B lymphocyte. These are increase in number D, increase immunoglobulin D, increase in number or quantity during allergic reactions to milk, insulin, penicillin, or other toxins, when body is allergic to some toxins or the some substances like milk or insulin or penicillin, the body produces more quantity of more number of antibody T, and it makes the 0.2%. And the question is formed for this is the antibody present on the surface of B cells okay. So what we have discussed, the different antibodies, the different classes of antibodies are the IgG, the most abundant IgA, the antibody which is present in the colostrum, milk, in the exocrine secretions, the tears, saliva, etc., and IgM, largest antibody, and E, anti-allergic, D, present on the surface of the B lymphocytes. Okay.